Hello MotoGP fans, welcome back to ZNGP today. Marc Márquez continues to reflect on his performance during the Emilia Romagna Grand Prix weekend. Despite a solid showing, the Gresini rider admits there are areas where his rivals still hold the upper hand. Speaking with DAZN after the second sprint of the year at Misano, Márquez offered insight into his mindset, race pace, and what he expects in Sunday's race. Let's dive into what Márquez had to say. In a highly competitive sprint race at the MotoGP Emilia-Romagna Grand Prix, Francesco Bagnaia capitalized on an error by Jorge Martin to secure victory. Despite setting a new lap record and starting from pole, Bagnaia found himself behind Martin after the start and had to wait for an opening. The reigning world champion reflected on the race, his physical condition, and the challenge of overtaking at Misano. Let's hear what Bagnaia had to say after the sprint race. It was a tough Saturday for KTM's Jack Miller at the MotoGP Emilia-Romagna Grand Prix, as the Australian rider struggled throughout the sprint race. Despite his efforts, Miller could only manage a 15th place finish, leaving him frustrated and searching for answers. Meanwhile, his teammate Brad Binder had a strong start but faced his own challenges with tire temperatures. Let's take a closer look at what Miller had to say after a difficult day at Misano. Don't forget to click subscribe button and the bell icon for MotoGP news update. After starting from 7th on the grid, Marc Márquez was able to secure 4th place in the Emilia-Romagna sprint race. While 4th may not be a podium finish, Márquez views it as a positive result, considering the performance gap between himself and riders like Francesco Bagnaia and Jorge Martin. Today I think that starting 2nd, we finished 4th. Starting 7th, we finished 4th. Starting 1st, we probably finished 4th, because that was the race pace we had. Quote from Marc Márquez. Márquez acknowledged that Bagnaia and Martin were a step ahead, with Bastianini also showing slightly better race pace. His goal for Sunday's race remains clear, to aim for 4th place, a position he feels is within reach. One of the key issues Márquez pointed out was tire performance. The Ducati rider explained that his struggles are more pronounced when the tires are fresh, but he becomes more competitive as the tires wear down. When the tire is completely new, that's where I suffer the most, where it costs me the most. In fact, today's fall in qualifying was a bit more of the same. Márquez admitted that his qualifying pace remains a weak point, but he is committed to trial and error, hoping to find a solution soon. His crash in qualifying was a reminder that mistakes are more costly when they happen in front of an audience. As for where his rivals hold the advantage, Márquez pointed out the fast corners at Misano as areas where Bagnaia and Martin have a clear edge. He plans to use a medium compound tire in Sunday's race, believing it will provide better stability than the soft option. Pecco and Martin also did 1:30 with the medium, so they'll be very fast. But if we try to be in fourth position, it will depend a lot on the start. Márquez explained that while starting positions are important, a good start will be crucial to securing the fourth place finish he's targeting. Márquez also spoke about the need to accept when other riders are faster, a key lesson in avoiding crashes. He noted that when riders push beyond their limits in an attempt to keep up with faster competitors, accidents often occur. It is about trying to add points in these races that are a little more difficult and accept that they go faster. When you don't accept that is when the falls come, Márquez concluded. With this realistic approach, Márquez hopes to continue gathering points, even in races where a podium finish seems out of reach. With a clear strategy in place and a focus on steady improvement, Marc Márquez is ready to fight for another solid result in Sunday's long race. While fourth place may not be the victory he desires, Márquez knows that consistency is key as the MotoGP season continues. Stay tuned to see how he performs in the Emilia-Romagna Grand Prix. Bagnaia's pole position gave him an ideal start, but it was Jorge Martin who took the lead off the line. For the first 7 laps, the two riders were evenly matched, but a small mistake from Martin at turn 13 on lap 8 allowed Bagnaia to overtake and take control of the race. Super happy for what happened for the race, because I think me and Jorge did something incredible in terms of pace, 6 seconds faster than 2 weeks ago. Quote from Francesco Bagnaia. Bagnaia credited his win to Martin's error, admitting that overtaking him without that mistake would have been extremely difficult. He noted that their pace was exceptional, comparing it to times fast enough to qualify on the second row. Bagnaia also mentioned that his improved physical condition played a big role in his performance, especially in the latter stages of the sprint. With 6 laps remaining, after overtaking Martin, Bagnaia was able to push harder and create a gap. My physical condition was better. So, I was able to use my body better to control the movement, to control the tires. Bagnaia said by crash. Bagnaia's ability to manage his body and the bike helped him hold onto the lead and take the checkered flag. He emphasized that while Martin's mistake was crucial, being physically 100% allowed him to capitalize on the opportunity and maintain control of the race. Looking ahead to Sunday's Grand Prix, Bagnaia acknowledged that overtaking Martin remains a significant challenge. He identified several corners, including turn 14, where he might attempt a pass, but also said he may have to come up with creative solutions if he finds himself behind Martin again. Every time we have to change direction is where I'm gaining a bit. It was risky for sure, but for tomorrow we will be important to invent something in case we are behind. Bagnaia understands that Misano's layout, combined with the current pace of the top riders, makes overtaking tricky. However, he's confident that he can find ways to gain an advantage if needed. One notable moment during the sprint occurred when Bagnaia had a big front-end moment at turn 5 just before overtaking Martin. He attributed this to the recently repainted white lines on the track, which he described as too slippery. The white lines after they repainted them are very slippery, and I don't think they did a good job in this case. Bagnaia concluded. Fortunately, Bagnaia was able to control the situation and continue the race without further issues, but it was a reminder of the fine margins that MotoGP riders must navigate. Francesco Bagnaia's sprint win has tightened the MotoGP championship fight, reducing Jorge Martin's lead to just 4 points ahead of Sunday's Grand Prix. With improved physical condition and a clear strategy, Bagnaia is prepared for another intense battle at Misano. Will he find a way to outmaneuver Martin again? Stay tuned for more action from the Emilia Romagna Grand Prix. Jack Miller's weekend got off to a rough start as he qualified 19th for the sprint race after a disappointing Q1 session. While his KTM teammate Brad Binder topped the session and later secured 4th, Miller found himself struggling at the back of the pack. Despite his best efforts, he could only finish 15th, nearly 20 seconds behind the race winner. I feel like I can't push anymore. I feel like on the wall for my riding, for my feeling with the bike. Quote from Jack Miller. Miller noted that his pace has been stuck compared to what he did at the San Marino GP, unable to find the extra speed needed to make a significant difference. Miller was clear that he and the KTM team need to find a way to break through the plateau they're currently facing. After finishing 15th in the sprint, Miller acknowledged that it's essential to discover something that will allow him to push harder. It's like a tenth off what I did last week in the sprint, so it seems like we're sort of just stuck around that number, and that's how it feels, Miller said. Miller is hoping to make improvements ahead of Sunday's Grand Prix, but it's clear that the team will need to make some adjustments to unlock more potential from the bike. While Miller had his struggles, Brad Binder also faced challenges of his own. After a strong start, Binder quickly found himself losing ground due to problems getting his medium front tire up to temperature. By the end of the first lap, Binder had dropped from 2nd to 5th and was struggling to keep pace with the leaders. I messed up the sprint because it took too long for the front tire to come up to performance, and I almost crashed and went wide in turn 11. Quote from Brad Binder. Binder admitted that he had 2 near crashes in the opening lap but managed to save the bike each time. Once the tire reached the right temperature, he was able to ride more comfortably, but by then it was too late to catch up to the leaders. Binder ultimately finished 6th, 8.1 seconds behind the winner. Team manager Francesco Guidotti described the day as bittersweet for the team. While Binder's performance in qualifying was one of their best results of the season, both riders struggled in the sprint race due to various issues. Brad took P1 and then P4 in the two qualifying sessions, one of the best outcomes this year, but he struggled with the front tire temperature in the race. Quote from Francesco Guidotti. Guidotti also reflected on Miller's struggles, acknowledging that starting from the back of the grid made the sprint race an uphill battle. However, the team remains optimistic about finding improvements ahead of the Grand Prix. Jack Miller's frustrations at Misano highlight the challenges he and the KTM team are facing as they look for a way to push past their current limits. With Brad Binder also battling tire issues, the team will need to make critical adjustments ahead of Sunday's race. Will KTM find the solution they need to deliver a stronger performance in the Grand Prix? Stay tuned for more from the Emilia Romagna Grand Prix. Thanks for watching ZNGP today, and this is your MotoGP news update. See you in the next video.